Hey, hey, Wallace here with another update on the Portax Chronicles account. I will start by talking about a general thing about account leveling. I've been getting a lot of questions about how I level so fast, how I get all those crystals, and so forth. So, if I should just start by answering the question of how I level so fast. I'm not totally sure if the question is about the account level or the monster levels, but they are almost identical, the answer for that anyway. As for the account level, I really just make sure that the energy storage, see now it's 14 out of 51, it will never, I prevent it from reaching max. I always use my energy, so it will not go to the max. So if it goes to max, you'll essentially be losing energy. And energy is experience, both for the account and the monsters. So that's basically how I level the account level. If the question was about the monsters, try to go over the logic again. It all depends on your team, but the further down this map you can go while leveling your monsters, the better. And also if you can raise the difficulty, even better. As for a comparison, if you clear, let's say, the sixth stage here on the Garen Forest, you'll be getting 500 and some experience. However, if you clear the sixth area here in Talane Forest, you'll be getting almost 1000 experience for each creature. So you really want to press your monsters as hard as you can, but still guarantee success. Now I have as you can see, I have cleared Talane Forest on hard as well. And what I've simply been doing is taking the Ramagos and the Light Imp we got yesterday, and the Wind Harpy, that is 4-star max level, and then also the Hellhound, which is 4-star as well. And I'm just hitting this level over and over now. So we can see if we just go back, I'm 68.4% into level 20. Now if I do this once, let's just use those. I'll talk a bit about the monsters later in the update, how Ramagos is looking and what I've been doing with the Light Imp. So we can see what we can utilize them for. I know yesterday that I talked about the Light Imp as a bad monster summon. Now, compared to what we could have gotten from the Light and Dark Scroll and that kind of jazz, it was a bad summon, but for the account, an awakened 2-star, who already is a 3-star, is a good addition. He can do some damage, and he is fairly easy to skill up, since he only needs other imps to do so, and they are 2-stars. And you'll get those from unknown scrolls on a fairly regular basis, so he will be skilled up fairly fast, I think. So that's really good. And you also really need to work with what you get. It can't really help that you sit around saying, oh my god, someone else summoned a 5-star or something. If it's not you, you can't really use it. Now you can see here, I'm getting 952 XP per creature here. The Harpy also gets 952 experience, but since it's max level, they are just thrown away. Now we'll get that. Just another thing here. There are some not first playthroughs players, but there are some that actually tries to get the Light and Dark Scroll as fast as they can with help from friends to clear the scenario. And when they've done so, they use it, and if it's not a lightning summon or something really, really rare, they will reset the account and try again. Now, when I first heard this a long time ago, I didn't actually know what they were talking about. But let me just show you so you also have that option. In here, under the Options tab, you have a button called Reset Game. If you press that, it will ask you to enter a digit code or a digit key and then press reset. Be warned though, everything from your account, well, not everything, but monsters, mana, crystals, buildings, everything is wiped. You'll start completely anew, a level 1 account, and you'll have to go through the tutorial. The only thing that you will keep is your friends on your friends list. They will not be reset. For those of you out there who has gotten the Light Fairy Queen, be very careful about resetting the account. You will not get that unit a second time. So it will be deleted as well. But it is an option to reset your account and just go back to level 1 and level the fastest you can through Fame on Volcano. Try the Light and Dark Scroll and see if you get lucky with Lightning Summon. Now, it's not something that you can do really, really fast. It will take time, even with a good friends list. But, well, I guess if you have 50 level 40 accounts, it will go pretty fast through the story, so you don't have to wait that long to see if you get a good lightning summon. But most of us don't have a friends list like that, so it's not really possible. But I'll just press cancel here. I do not want to reset this account. Also, for the monster level, you also have the option of boosting your creatures fairly aggressively. Oh, I don't have a friend unit. Okay. In essence, if you, let's say we want to boost the Light Imp as much as we can, we'll just add that. And then a very strong friend. Now, this unit is not strong enough to clear this level, but let's say it was. Friends units will not take any of the experience. So when this level is cleared, we saw we got almost 1,000 experience per monster. All the almost 4,000 experience will be given to the Light Imp if we clear this level, since I'm using a friend. So if you want to boost a single unit really, really fast, this is the way to do it. But of course it requires strong friends. But it's also an option you can think about. Now to get back to the account. As you see, I have cleared the first 5 areas on hard mode now. And really the Talain Forest I only did because the experience were better and my units also fit quite well. I've played a lot more in Mount White Dragoon as well to farm for these raid runes. I'll get back to why. So, well, I'll just sure at once. The monsters that I've been focusing on since yesterday is, of course, the Remagus. He was level 25 yesterday, and he is again, but he's now 4-star. So that's the real reason. And I also have him ruined now, so he has he has 10,500 hit points. Which, if we compare it to some of the others, are roughly twice as much. So he's a really good tank now. He's comparable, but he only has half. He's quite a beast now. His defense is also fairly high, but that's because I haven't been able to find a very good second rune for him yet, but it will be swapped out for an HP rune later. Now the one slot has an HP percent substat. The second rune has the defense, but also some HP percent. The third rune was that I put in it last night, and it has 11%. I found it. 2-star rune here with HP percent on it, so it will need replacing. Now I got this from a Giant's Keep run. It has HP percent also and a fair amount of defense. So that's why I added that to the mix, and that rune he already had. So I can boost him up fairly well if I get another HP rune here or something better here. As for the skills, I've actually added 3 skill ups to him. Sadly, none of them went into clean shot, but we'll get that eventually. Now the other unit I've been focusing on was this light imp. Now he, what I did with him, I really based on his third skill, the Awakened skill. Since it receives a 50% critical rate bonus, I only need to get the crit rate to 50%, and the third skill will always crit. So that's what I based him on. So I ruined him Rage Blade. Although this rune is a crit rate rune at the moment, it would be nice to get a crit damage instead. I know that the crit rate here will drop the 17%, but the damage will be that much higher when he does crit. So I got a fairly good rune set for him farming in Mount Ragoon, White Ragoon. Got a 3-star one slot here, substats or nothing, but it's still a 3-star. Got this attack percent rune, not from farming, that's a blade rune, but I had that in storage. Got a 4-star rune here with a little crit rate and some HP percent, then the 17% crit rate rune. A 3-star rune here also with attack and crit damage. And here a 3-star attack percent rune with bad substats though. So he will hit fairly hard now. But of course I need to make him a 4-star also and get him some better runes eventually. But he will, the third skill will hit for a bit over 2,000 now. So that's okay. Now also currently, I know this is not a general advice, but currently this Cherry Blossom event is going on, and essentially it wants to make you clear 30 stages of a scenario, and that's just doing what I've been doing. Leveling up. I'm at 23. And if you do, as you can see here, if you Use the Cherry Blossom Drill 5 times, you'll get a Mystical Scroll, and if you do it 10 times, you'll get 100 crystals. And each time you draw, you can get any of these items. Now, I have done one draw, and I got the energy, which were 50 energy. So that's pretty well, and pretty good. So I'll be using that. It's still in restored. I'll be using that after this video to farm the last 7. So I have the 30 scenarios done today. Also, of course, we have kept up with the arena fights and more so those with the crystals. So I'm up to 722 crystals. Getting really, really close. And actually, let's just see if we get those last crystals with the wish today. So we need to have it land on 100 crystals. And it will not. I think 10,000 maybe? No, it's 5. Okay, 5,000 mana. Okay, that's nothing special really. Talking about wishes, I need to throw that in here. One of my guildmates actually landed on the monster icon today, and he was given a Dark Archangel from this wishing well. I'm just putting it out there so you know that it's a possibility. It is most certainly not guaranteed if you land on the monster monster icon. You can also get 3 stars from that. So if you land there, it's totally random. I'm not sure how they calculate which monster you'll get. But he got a Dark Archangel. A really, really, really rare monster. So you can always cross your fingers each time you do a wish to see if it doesn't land on the monster icon. Oh dear, I lost my way. Where was I? We also need to start doing the Trial of Ascension. I've only cleared one level here, and I should be able to clear more with the current monsters. But I don't think I'm gonna do it today. Since I want to save the energy for clearing the scenarios, and I want to level up my monsters just a bit more, especially the Remagus and Light Imp Taru. And one other monster that I want to talk a bit about is the Rainbow Mon. Now, Rainbow Mons cannot be taken into battle. They can only be used really to evolve creatures. So in essence, when you get them, they are always max level. If it's a 2-star as this, it will be level 20. If it's a 3-star, it will be level 25. So in essence, what you do when you get these is just put them in the power up circle and just choose 2 random other 2-stars and evolve it. So it will be a 3-star. So you can use that to evolve a max level 3-star to a 4-star. That is in essence what they are there for. You can level them up by putting in here and just feeding other monsters to it. But you might as well use other monsters for it. You don't really need to do it with Angel Mons. They will not level up faster than any other monsters. They will level up in the exact same velocity. Also, if I power up the Hellhound with another Hellhound, you will see that I'll of course get the experience. This time I'll get 1.5 times the experience. Then it was a lightning power, but I'll also get a skill gain since the creatures were of the same type. So this is the way to level up skills. I know I haven't been over that little feature in the first video, but it should really have been in some of the earlier episodes, so I apologize for that. Also, I used a lot of unknown scrolls, I think about 37, and I actually got two lightning summons. One were the Water Magical Archer, the other were the Fire Minotaurus. Now, personally, I really don't find any of these to be any good. So what they are good for is making a new 4-star for the account. The question, however, is who should I choose? I'm leaning towards waiting for the Light Imp to reach level 25, because I think that he will actually bring the most damage. He is, however, very squishy, so I could go for the Water Warbear also, but I'm pretty sure I'm gonna wait for the Light Imp to reach level 25, so I can make him the next 4-star. Awakened monsters are all do have higher stats, and he's almost guaranteed to crit with his third skill, and it will hit very, very hard, so he will be good in arena as well. And he is fairly fast as well, so he should go quite early in the rotation. Just take these mana. But I actually think that was the... I don't think my honor is that high. No. Arena was reset today, so when you enter the arena for the first time, you will probably be facing quite weak enemies. So you will be able to farm quite a lot of glory today, at least in the beginning. So take a notice of that and use those arena invites. And you probably have noticed I do have reached level 20 and are closing in on 21. So I think at the moment I'll be doing just about a level a day, I think it is, if I continue to use all the energy that is on the account. So we'll see, we'll see. But that's the update for today. I've been, oh dear, it's over 20 minutes. I'll better cut this video short then. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll bring you more tomorrow. This will be Waldest signing out. Bye-bye.